reporting his car is tight in the center of the corners. That will get a chassis adjustment. The wrench is going in both sides. Those are wedge adjustments, air pressure as well. Chad Knaus telling his driver, we'll try to free you up a little bit, buddy. Tires going on the left-hand side, and now he leaves pit road. Alan.
And you see Kurt Busch on the left-hand screen pitting from second place to where he's running before the round of pit stops started. Trouble in turn two, trouble in the pit entrance.
Caution it out.
8 car, Dale Earnhardt Jr. sideways. You see him getting back on the racetrack. The 29 of Harvick down there trying to avoid trouble as well. And caution comes out as you see Jeff Gordon in the pits for his first stop of the day. Left side tires, Steve Letard and crew getting 4 tires on. You hear most of these guys complaining of the cars being tight.
It's going to shuffle them up a little bit because all of them had not made their pit stops.
Yeah, you got half of them on the racetrack, half of them on pit road right now, Andy. This has got everything totally confused right now when it comes to pit strategy.
Folks, Jimmy Johnson, it would be a lap down right now by virtue of making that pit stop and others that haven't pitted yet. Now, let's show you what happened here trying to get on to pit road.
We talked to Carl Edwards. He's our in-race reporter about this narrow pit road is very tough. And we saw a race leader last night, David Reagan, spin, but he gets hit. He's on or out in the dirt. He's trying to get back in. Massive melee at the entry of pit road here at Homestead.
That was Kyle Busch in the 5 car that got into the 8 car of Earnhardt Jr. You saw Patrick Carpentier was there as well in the 10. There's the damage on the left rear of the 8 car. We are being told that NASCAR is going to call the 8 and 29 in for commitment cone violations. Once you come to that commitment cone, you got to come on the pit road. And he came back on the racetrack.
They definitely violated the commitment cone. They were both crashing as they went by.
And to avoid that 8 car not to hit him in the side door there, you know what I mean?
Hey, you got these leaders right here. Looks like Tony Stewart wanted to pit, but you have to pit from the access road. You can't come in off the racetrack right there.
You have to come in off of the end of the back straightaway in turn 3. So he turned down pit road. He would have had a commitment cone violation.
That's kind of confusing here at this racetrack because it looks like you can come right off the track on the pit road, but NASCAR requires these guys to use the access road, just like you saw where the 8 and the 5 car got together.
You know, it makes you wonder. We saw last night in that Busch Series race when David Reagan spun out and crashed on the entry. It's got to be in these drivers' mind because this road is so narrow. I mean, there's been many cars sliding off in the dirt trying to pit.
Looks like his 5 car's got some damage. He's got a lot of damage on that headlight door. Alan?
Kyle Busch was one of those guys who had not yet pitted before that caution came out, which could turn out to be a good break. We'll have to wait and see. He does have some damage behind the left front wheel and in front of the left front wheel. They've got fender damage there from contact. You see them also working around the right front side of the car. So nose damage on this machine from that whole scramble there. That brought the caution out in the middle of the green flag stops, and that's too bad. Casey Kane, when Kyle Busch went by him on the racetrack, said that 5 car is going to win the race tonight. He had a good run going in the early part. Now those fenders, it's going to be hard on a fast track like this with those aerodynamics all messed up.
Alan, Tony the Tiger there on the hood a little bit bent up here. Watch the violation now. Watch her trying to see here. There's the 8 of Earnhardt Jr. That was a cone. They went back up on the racetrack. So the 29 and 8 commitment cone violations. 9 cars up front had not yet pitted, including Ryan Newman, Tony Stewart, Juan Pablo Montoya, Reed Sorensen and company. And here they come on the pit road. They slow down at 45 miles an hour for their first stop of the day. Jamie.